Hey, Matt 31, Mr. Braille here. I have a question coming out of section 2.1, number 49. And here we were given a function and asked to find the y-intercept. So if I want to do that, I'm going to go over to my y equals. And I actually made a screencast for number 53 just yesterday. So I'm going to change this out. This function is actually 3x minus 8. And I need to divide, by 4. So that pretty much stays the same. And if you watch my screencast for number 53, just so you know, you could distribute that fourth, that division by 4 to both terms, and you could say this was 3/4 x minus 2. And where I'm getting the 2 is that 8 divided by 4 is the number 2. So you can write either of these equations in, they're equivalent. I'm just going to go ahead and stick with the first one. Now, whenever I'm in a math problem, I want to hit zoom 6. So I activate that zoom, and you can either scroll down to 6 and hit enter. I like to play the lazy card, so I'm just gonna hit the number 6. There's my graph. And if I'm looking at this, if I gotta guess, I don't know, the y-intercept looks like it's close to negative 2 if I was guessing, but let's use our calculator to help us with that. So we're gonna go into our calc menu, and it's in blue, so I'm gonna hit second and technically the trace button, because that'll call up my calc menu. Now, we're gonna just find a value for this y-intercept, so I'm gonna hit enter, and you'll always be prompted with the x value. What x value do you wanna plug in? Well, whenever you wanna find a y-intercept, you should let x equal 0. And so if I hit enter, let's see what the y-intercept is. Oh, it actually is negative 2. So the y-intercept for this particular line is 0 comma negative 2. And make sure you're writing it up as an ordered pair, 0 comma negative 2, not just negative 2. So that's our y-intercept, and that's how I found it on my calculator. All right, thanks so much, everyone. Bye.